This is my 93 version of the build, so I finally got the red dream to actually work.
One of my captors refused redemption. He did not see
that. That guy wouldn't be nice with chain. This is the first T16 I've done with this build so far. I've gone with Basalt plus the Roomies just because I don't think the Jade Flask will help much in the Minotaur fight. There's one hit. It's better to mitigate than to hope that you evade it. And yeah, even with 12% chance to gain endurance charge on kill, get the endurance charges rather quick. I'm thinking about putting it at Scion, which would put it at a 28% chance to get endurance charge on kill. Up to 75. I love it when breaches are up against the wall. Although this wall is a bit close to a pathway. If it's in a big open area, you can just sit at the wall. And everything is in front of you. You don't have to worry about looking where all the mobs are potentially spawning. Like over here. Boss spawns, you don't have to go rushing towards it, or potentially not know it exists at all. If I swapped out the red dream for another jewel with like 7% life, I think I'd be about 6.8k. Not sure with vulnerability if I'd survive. Even with 6.8k against some of the Minotaur's attacks, though. That's what we're going to find out, isn't it? I just leveled up as well, so not too worried if I do die. I think getting one more level on this build would be nice, but I've got another build planned. I'll level it with SRS and then convert to an Aurobot Necromancer. I'm going to try using the new Esh shield instead of Shavs, at first anyway. Once I get some more currency, I'll do Shavs. Alright, so taunt him. Get out of his way. Alright, how's the damage? Oh! Whoa, 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 whoa. Damage isn't massive, but he died fairly quick. I think 6.8 would have been a lot safer than this, but He only got us down to 5% HP. It's like, you're either dead or you're not. bit scary. Anyway, so that's Castwind Channel, Firestorm, with Chaos and all that sort of stuff.